Hi everyone, this is Lanner Smith from Since Memory, and finally, we're getting to the Americans, the American collections that I have, and surprisingly enough, it is a very small collection. Most of my fragrances are either French or Italian, or from some other part of the world. So let's get into it right away. The first one is Aramis, and I'm going to give three impressions of the fragrance, not this note, not the year it was made or anything like that, but just three words to give you an impression of what I feel about this fragrance. Iconic, the West, rugged sophistication. On to the next one. The next one is by Ralph Lauren. And no, it's not Polo Green, the original Ralph Lauren, but it is Safari for Men. So what do I think of this one? Big 80s class and classic, challenging. The next one is Tom Ford's Patchouli Absolue. Green, wealthy ease, elegant. The next one is Canoe by Dana. This is from the 60s, and this is a vintage bottle. Collegiate sophistication, New England fall. Easy and relaxed. The next one, I just got this bottle. It's Obsession. It's interesting to revisit this after all these years. I haven't smelled this or owned this in 40 years or however long it's been. New York autumn. By that I mean Manhattan in the autumn. Well, upstate New York too. Pastry, burning wood fires. The next one is, the next one's Aramis Devon. There you see this beautiful bottle. I have a lot of Aramis collections because I've just fallen in love with the line, and their fragrances are really wonderful. Let's get this, here we go. Oh, this one, this is really beautiful. And it reminds me so much of Gucci Envy, which sells for like over $300 a bottle now on eBay. This is a beautiful, I'm saying too much about it, I just go on, but it really is something. Summer in smoke, it is really beautiful. The next one is also by Aramis, and this one is Havana. And my impressions of this one, beach grass, sunny and vibrant. And now that's followed by Aramis Tuscany. I really went all out on this line. It's just such a great line of men's fragrances. Cypress trees in summer, classic. And pepper trees at night. It's very, very beautiful. And the last one is Aramis 900. This is a new acquisition, and I actually, a friend of mine, the man who cuts my hair, told me about it and wore it one day, and I fell in love with it. Sports, fast sports cars. Adventure. Classic. Now we come to a really interesting vintage fragrance that I have that is Scoundrel. And this is by Revlon, I believe. Let's see. It doesn't say, but I believe it's by Revlon. And there it is. This was advertised on television around the time of Dynasty, and the spokesperson was Joan Collins. There was a commercial she did on how to start a fire, and this was involved. It's like a light version of Elizabeth Taylor's Passion. Sporty glamour and languid luxury. It's beautiful. And what a great bottle. Really beautiful little bottle. So there you have it. And we don't want another accident like we had with Sophia Loren. Sophia. The next one is Passion by Elizabeth Taylor. And this bottle is actually signed. Have I got it upside down? I do. There you see. Okay, let's get to this one. And this too is a dabber. You have to be very careful. This was her first fragrance. It's kind of forgotten. It's definitely violet. Night. Seduction, class and classic. The next one is Extravagance Russe by Diana Vreeland. There you see this beautiful bottle. Smart, fun, vital. Now we come to a rather controversial fragrance that a lot of people just don't get. But to me, it's class and classic. There it is. It's Geoffrey Beene's Grey Flannel. Elegant, sophisticated, an oak panel bar in Manhattan. It's just beautiful. So don't believe the anti-hype. It really is a great classic fragrance. And last, we have vintage Elizabeth Taylor's White Diamonds. This is from the very first release. I bought it at Macy's when it first came out, and there's a long story about that. Elizabeth Taylor was there, and she talked about her fragrance, talked about her life, took questions from the audience, and she winked at me, which was great. So this is the original. I would say this is what I would call the American Chanel. It has that kind of DNA that Chanel has. And Bel Air Hotel, it's summer. at the nighttime, the last superstar. I also have a brand new bottle, and I'm going to do a comparison of the two coming up in a few days, a few weeks, so it'll be soon. And so there you have my Americans and my impressions. This is Leonard Smith from Since Memory saying, remember, wear what you love and not what they say you should like. Cheers.